most young girls reach the age of 16, their hopes and dreams are still ahead. For Shannon Miller, she has already lived those dreams. When Shannon won two silver medals at the 1991 World Championships, people took notice of this shy young gymnast from Oklahoma. And at the experienced age of 15 last summer in Barcelona, Shannon won five medals, including a silver in the all-around. So when Shannon was given a sweet 16 diamond pendant on her birthday recently in Oklahoma City, most of her dreams were already coming true. Today on U.S. Olympic Gold, Shannon and 25 other Olympians are at the Reebok International Mixed Pairs Competition. It is yet another opportunity for Shannon to showcase her talent and just maybe to show off her new diamond. Welcome to Atlanta, Georgia. Not only the site for the 1996 Summer Olympics, but also the host for today's gymnastics competition. Hello everyone, I'm Nicole Watson. Welcome to U.S. Olympic Gold. The format of mixed pairs competition was first introduced in 1979 as an opportunity for the men and women to compete together for a combined score. Well, this event is now an official part of the Goodwill Games and will debut next summer in St. Petersburg, Russia. Today's program marks the return of Olympian Dominique Dawes, who suffered from tendonitis in her right ankle after the Olympics and was in a cast for 6 weeks. Well, the one they call Awesome Dawson is back. Now, noticeably absent is Kim Zemeskal. After collecting her team bronze medal in the 92 Games, Kim is currently training and showcasing her talent in gymnastics exhibitions. So look for the other marquee names, including 92 Olympians Chris Waller and his partner, Carrie Strug. Later in the program, we'll visit Carrie at her home in Oklahoma City, where she is currently training. For now, we just have to go a few blocks south to watch these world-class gymnasts perform because they're right here in Atlanta. So let's send it over to the Omni with Bart Conner and Kathy Johnson for the Reebok International Mixed Pairs Competition.
Welcome to the Omni Arena here in Atlanta. It's the 1993 Reebok International Mixed Pairs Gymnastics Championships. Hi everyone, I'm Bart Conner, and this is perhaps one of the more unique events on the international gymnastics calendar because it's the only time during the year that the men and women gymnasts add their scores together in a combined mixed pair format. Now the way this competition works, there are 14 pairs that will compete in the first round. They whittle that down to the top seven in the second round, and only three pairs go on to the final round. The scores do carry over. So at the end of the third round, we will be able to name our new champion. And joining me, as always, is Olympic medalist Kathy Johnson. And Kathy, are you impressed with the group of gymnasts who have come here? Certainly there are 16 countries represented, but perhaps more importantly, 16 medals from the Olympics, eight of them gold. It's quite a good field.
Very impressive, Bart. Certainly two of the most celebrated Olympic gymnasts are Vitaly Scherbo of the former unified team, now competing for Belarus, winner of six Olympic gold medals in Barcelona. And of course, Shannon Miller of the United States, winner of five medals, including the silver medal in the all-around. They're both here and both in fine form, and you really have to hand it to them. So many gymnasts retire after the Olympic Games, and understandably so. They've achieved what many consider the highest attainable goal. They've gone through a long, intense training period leading up to the Olympic Games, so usually it's time to retire. So let's hand it to these guys. They're back in the gym, and that can be tough, and they're jumping right back into competition.
Now, in this mixed pairs format, Vitaly Scherbo's partner is 15-year-old Yelena Piskun from Belarus, and also from the United States, Shannon Miller. Her teammate is Lance Ringnall, two-time Olympian. So they are our favorites, but there are other some good teams here as well.
Of course, the team, Carrie Strug and Chris Waller of the United States, will give them a good run for the money. And I think the Chinese gymnasts, they do beautiful gymnastics, but they'll have to be consistent.
In addition to this unique mixed pairs format, the gymnasts will also be tested because there's a completely new rules scoring system. All the gymnasts are required to do a much higher level of difficulty than in the past. So we're in for one great gymnastics competition. Now we open the competition on the floor exercise. From Belarus, this is Yelena Piskun. She, of course, is teamed up with Olympic champion Vitaly Scherbo. Yelena is 15 years old and relatively new to international competition.
And Bart, at the recent American Cup, she performed this exact floor exercise routine, and its start value score, which means determined by the difficulty in the routine, it only was worth a 9.8. Height, full twisting double back. Excellent first pass.
Yeah.
this is the tumbling run that she had trouble with at the American Cup. Let's see if she can do it here. Whip that. There's the full. Do it to a double twist. Watching very closely the execution of the skills in order to give them credit for bonus points when they do more difficult skills or more difficult combinations. Triple twist, beautifully done, a slight hop on the landing, but wonderfully executed in the air. Nice exercise.
A strong start for the first half of the team from Belarusia.
Quite simply, for the audience to know when a routine is very difficult, particularly on the floor exercise, when you see a triple twist. This is Yelena's second tumbling pass. She received a tenth of a point bonus for doing these skills in combination. Whip back through to a full twist. Now watch here, she goes right through to a double twist. It's really not the most difficult pass, but it merits her a tenth of a point bonus.
Now on the vault, this is Vitaly Scherbo. This is one of the more difficult vaults being done.
Oh, a little low on the landing. But as you said, that is a difficult vault, a double twist in the air. Very few gymnasts doing that.
Vitaly Scherbo, of course, the winner of 6 gold medals, a record at the Olympics in Barcelona. This is one of Scherbo's best events, obviously, not that they're all not fantastic. This is a Yurchenko, and he goes off the horse with a laid out double twisting backflip. It's worth a 9.8. It's one of the more difficult vaults being done. It's just a little short on the landing. As you can see here, there's a lot happening in the air.
Beautiful execution on the air. I think he was just a little relaxed coming off the horse. He's so used to being able to do so, things so easily.
Well, he's had a busy week.
Yeah.
Just recently, he and his wife, Irina, had a young baby girl named Christina, so he spends his nights changing diapers and staying up with the baby. So his life has changed a great deal in the last few months.
In fact, he flew in late to the competition, just arrived a few hours before warm-ups.
The score on the floor exercise.
Score now for the pair from Belarus.
We know the start value. As I said, it was a 9.8 at American Cup, and that's exactly what it's worth here, even with all the difficulty. It really shows how much harder it is to have a routine score a 10.0 or even a high 9.9.
This is Dominique Dawes, a member of the Olympic team, won a bronze medal in Barcelona, and she was an exciting story. She's 16 years old from Gaithersburg, Maryland. She's a national champion on this event right now.
She has an extremely nice combination coming up right here. Kachev. Uprise to handstand. Now watch this, see if she makes it. Full and a half pirouette. Right down to low bar into handstand. Very nicely done. Now the judges are gonna be very strict to see if she did that pirouette right in the handstand. Full twisting double back, just a slight hop on the landing, but beautiful exercise. And I heard the judges talking before the competition that because of where they're sitting, which is not the normal place, that they're not sure if they could see if the gymnast was going to complete those pirouettes in handstand. Here's the release move. She goes right back into an uprise to handstand. All of these elements combined give her lots of bonus points. Makes this routine worth a 10.0.
You're taking a look there at 25-year-old Greg Curtis from Carmel, New York. He's now training out in Colorado Springs with Ron Brandt at the Olympic Training Center. We talked about this new training program.
Well, my coach Ron Brandt has had the program for about 4 years now. I've been there 3 years. And we have people like J.D. Reeve, one of the up-and-coming stars. We have a Kyle Asano there. And we just have a really good group, great coach. He organized the program very well. He knew what he wanted. He wrote down his goals. And he really just took the program and went with it. What we want to do is get as many national team members as possible there, give them, send them money, whatever it takes to get them there, and train them together as a team like you guys did in 84, so that we can have some cohesion. and really learn about each other and feel comfortable competing with each other. So more of a team atmosphere.
Greg Curtis from New York, Winter Cup national champion this year. Well done on the vault. The vault is called a Kasamatsu, invented by Shigeru Kasamatsu. He's getting a high five or high 10 from Kurt Thomas, former three-time world champion from the U.S. Kurt's been working with Greg. Good push off the horse, and look how far away he is from the horse. That counts for bonus points from the judges. Another good angle of just how high and clean that vault was. The maximum value for that vault is a 9.5, however. Be interesting to see what the judges do with that. That's one of those vaults that has basically been downgraded. It used to be worth more than that. And now the judges are demanding that the gymnasts do more flips and more twists and a higher level of difficulty.
Many of the skills have been downgraded because they've been used so often and so many gymnasts do them. The judges wanted to encourage a variation of moves.
So you have the scores there. Dominique Dawes has a 9.8 on the uneven bars. You can see why they call her Awesome Dawson, and a 9.233 for Greg Curtis on the vault, and that puts them in first place.
U.S. Olympic gold is brought to you by Reebok, who reminds you that on Planet Reebok, there are no limits.
Now we go back over to the uneven bars from China. This is Hei Shua Mei. She's 16 years old from the People's Republic of China. She, of course, was a member of the Chinese team that was so impressive in Barcelona, but came up just short by winning the fourth place in the team competition and edged out by the American women for the bronze.
And like so many of her Chinese teammates, she is excellent on this event. You'll see right off the bat, she has beautiful form, straight body handstand, perfect toe point, leg straight. And this is my favorite move coming up right here into eagle grips. Now an eagle giant. Watch the height on this front somersault. You see she has a slight bend of her knee on those giants. I think the judges are going to see that. She's disappointing me a little bit on her form, but the skill level is beautiful. The straight body handstands are nice, but as I said, slight knee bend. Feet coming apart every now and then. Those will add up, but there's slight deductions.
We talk so much about the judging of these routines. Let's take a look at this replay now from the perspective of a judge and see exactly what they're looking for.
You can see on this sheet of paper that the first important element is a B, and it's followed by a C. And when you see the plus one there, that means because she has a C and a D directly together, she has a bonus because of the difficulty of that connection. And then she has another bonus of plus two because she directly connects one D with another D. And then we go on through the routine and you see again a B and a B and two more Ds that are directly connected. And because of this, she has plus two bonus again. And then another B, and she dismounts with a D element, which is your double salto with a full twist on the first salto. So since she has one D that's required and four Ds that are extra, she has full bonus because each of those are worth 1/10 extra. So this lady is starting out already with a 10-point exercise.
And a judge has figured that out in about 60 seconds, written the entire routine as the gymnast is performing. I think the judges are working just about as hard as the gymnast.
I would agree with that, Kathy. I'd support you on that one.
Thanks a lot.
Now over to the high bar. This is Li Dashuang from China, 19 years old. He has a very exciting high bar routine with three big release moves. Here they come. There's one, two, and here comes the third. Well done. He was a member of the silver medal winning Chinese team in the Barcelona Olympics. All he has left is the dismount. Very high. Interesting story about Li Dashuang. He has a twin brother who is 5 minutes younger. His twin won the gold medal on the high bar at on the floor exercise at Barcelona. But as you can see on the high bar here, this is the sequence. The three release moves, tremendous height, perfect position. His dismount on this routine was a laid out double backflip with a full twist. He had to pike it in a little bit there, but he was very high and very clean in the air. We have the scores for the Chinese team. Hei Shua Mei had a 9.75 on the uneven bars. Score is a 9.233 on the high bar, so it leaves them now in second place behind Dawes and Curtis from the United States. Cherbo and Kuskuner in third. Now getting ready to perform on the uneven bars, this is Carrie Strug, member of the World Championship team in 91 and 92, and of course, a bronze medalist in the 92 Olympics. And Kathy, this sets up an interesting situation because the rules state that because there are more American pairs than other teams in this competition, that although there are 14 people in the first round, only two American pairs at the most can qualify to the second round of seven. So there's a lot of pressure on here because Dominique Dawes and Greg Curtis did a terrific job in this round.
And we still have Shannon Miller and Lance Rignall to go. But I'm very impressed with Carrie Strug and her response to the new code. She is really upgrading her level of difficulty on all her routines.
Carrie, of course, was coached by Jim Gault in Arizona and then Bella Caroli and Kevin and Rita Brown and now Steve Nuno.
Her full pirouette into her release move. She has certainly cleaned up her form as well, and her amplitude is much greater. Great dismount coming up. Full twisting double back, but she does the full twist a little later in the somersault. And look at that landing. Can't do that any better than that. And
great
a smile.
Performance from Carrie Strug and a little smile, which you don't see too often.
She's a very serious little gymnast. And that made her happy.
Let's take a look at this full out, Kathy.
Beautiful height above the bar, and you can see she starts into the somersault before she starts her twist.
Now over to the pommel horse from Carrie Strug, who got off to a terrific start for that pair on the uneven bars. This is Chris Waller, who is a former national champion in the U.S. and a finalist at the Olympic Games on this event. So he has a spectacular horse routine. He opens with the Thomas Flares and a spindle and travels across the horse. Well done. Down and back, showing excellent difficulty in this exercise. Once again, the judges are requiring the gymnast to do a higher level of difficulty than in the past. All right, so Chris Waller puts in a strong performance. And as we said, there is a competition within a competition. The other American pair of Dominique Dawes and Greg Curtis got off to a terrific start, and we will yet see Shannon Miller and Lance Rignall. So these scores are critical. Picking up after the scissors, the single leg work, Chris does what a move called a care out to the end and breaks back into the Thomas Flares. He really is very clean. Notice he goes up to the handstand and then spins and travels through to the middle of the horse. So the score for Carrie Strug on the uneven bars was a 9.80, and the score for Chris Waller on the pommel horse, a 9.233. That exactly ties them with Dominique Dawes and Greg Curtis of the United States. We'll be back with more of the 1993 Reebok International Mixed Pairs Gymnastics Championships right after this. We'll be right back.
up on the pirouette.
As we continue in the first round of competition, this is Shannon Miller getting ready to go on one of her best events, the uneven bars. Steve Nuno giving some last-minute pointers. Now, Kathy, there's an interesting competition within a competition, and it's happening here. The American pairs of Dominique Dawes and Greg Curtis are tied with Carrie Strug and Chris Waller. They're all tied for first place. So they're going to have to break that tie because, as we mentioned, only two American pairs can go to the second round of competition, which features the top seven out of this group. So there's a lot of pressure on Shannon here to put in a strong performance right now.
They certainly are the favorites in the competition, but they've got some high scores to beat. Shannon can certainly do it on this event. She is the silver medalist at the World Championships in Indianapolis on the uneven bars, and the bronze medalist at the Olympic Games in Barcelona. She has one of the most difficult uneven bar routines in the world. Watch, everything finishes right in handstand. This is beautiful. Full over the bar into a ginger. Now she's going to do one more full pirouette right here, right in handstand, into a second release move. Now this is a new dismount for Shannon. She wanted to upgrade the difficulty, double layup. Even though she didn't need to upgrade the difficulty, they figured they ought to go ahead and do it now in preparation for the World Championships.
Great routine for Shannon Miller. And as you mentioned, a routine that's just packed with difficulty. Under any scoring system, that's going to score well.
This is beautiful. Full over the top of the bar. She has to adjust just slightly so she can go into this first release move. Beautiful form. She never lets those legs separate. Now this is the dismount I told you we need to see more of, a double layout somersault. We've seen a lot in tucked and pike position, but this is more difficult.
Should be a strong score for Shannon Miller. Now her teammate, Lance Ringnall from Albuquerque, New Mexico, is an interesting story. Lance basically retired after the Olympics in Barcelona, and he said he was going to sign up and go to classes and take classes at the University of New Mexico, and he signed up late. They wouldn't let him in class, so he started hanging around the gym, and before he knew it, he was back into gymnastics, and now he'll be competing in the World Championships in England and looking really good. This is the Yurchenko vault. Well done.
Nice vault in the air. Of course, he'll get the deduction for the hop on the landing. He's one of only a few gymnasts to perform that vault in men's vaulting. It's very, very common in women's.
Lance is coached by Ed Berger, Gold Cup gymnastics.
This vault is rated as a maximum of a 9.5. He shows good form, nice position in the air, just a hop on the landing.
I think it really shows how aggressive the men's side of gymnastics is being with the level of difficulty. That vault, only a few gymnasts have ever performed the Yurchenko vault on the men's side of gymnastics, and yet it's only valued at a 9.5 now. They're really looking ahead.
Here we go. The score for Shannon Miller is a 9.85. And the score for Lance Ringnall is a 9.2. So they move into first place in the first round of competition here. And they're going to have to break the tie of the other American pairs of Dominique Dawes and Greg Curtis, and Carrie Strug and Chris Waller, to see which of those pairs will advance into the second round, because as we mentioned, only two American teams can go into the second round of competition. In fourth place is a Chinese pair of Hei Shua Mei and Li Dashuang.
Every day all over America in gyms like these, more than 1.5 million kids are participating in the sport of gymnastics. However, every 4 years, only 6 men and 6 women actually make the U.S. Olympic team. Well, with the odds so slim that a young boy or a young girl will actually make the Olympics, why are so many kids turned on to gymnastics? Well, because it's a whole lot of fun. Let's take a look.
Gymnastics schools now offer programs for children as young as 2 years old, where the basics of tumbling and motor skills development are disguised as fun and games. As the kids get older, balance and power and coordination are the keys well before competition becomes a factor. For those that have the competitive spirit and the talent, there are USA Gymnastics events on 10 developmental levels all the way up to the elite or Olympic level. Although gymnastics is primarily a sport for young people, every once in a while, you'll even find a few more mature gymnasts who still like to get out there and tumble. We'll be back with more of Gymnastics right after this. Welcome back once again to the Omni Arena in Atlanta as we continue our coverage of the 1993 Reebok International Mixed Pairs Gymnastics Championships. Here are your results after the first round of competition. Miller and Rignall are in first place. There's a tie for second place, Strug and Waller, and Dawes and Curtis. Then in fourth place, Hay and Lee from China. Belarus is in fifth place, Piskun and Sherbo. Porta Carrero and Plus are in sixth. And seventh place goes to Stopchataya and Sharipov from the Ukraine. Now, with this complicated tie-breaking procedure, unfortunately, the American team of Dawes and Curtis get pulled out because, as we said, only two American pairs can advance to the second round of competition. So that is a fortunate thing for Amanda Borden and Neil Thomas, the mixed pair, who will move up into the seventh spot and move on into the second round of competition. Well, based on a very strong performance of this team, they moved on into the second round of competition. This is Amanda Borden on the vault.
This is her weakest event, handspring front vault. Big hop and a run at the end of that landing.
She, of course, is paired up with Neil Thomas from Great Britain, who will be performing on one of his better events, the floor exercise. She really overdid this vault, didn't she?
You can see here, good takeoff. She tucks into the somersault way too soon and really causes the over-rotation. Now, one of the new rules, which will have the greatest impact, I think, in women's gymnastics, is the fact in competition two, which is all around competition, they now will average the two vaults. They can perform the same vault, but they have to average them. That usually only happens in event finals. So it really puts a lot of pressure on the gymnast to hit both vaults.
The score for Amanda Borden, 9.3 on her first vault.
That's out of a start value of 9.7. It's one of the weaker vaults in the competition.
But it's interesting because the judges are seeming to encourage the gymnasts to do handspring-type vaults because 9.7 is a high value for that vault.
I think through the years we've really seen so many Yurchenkos that they want to get back to some traditional vaulting as well. There you go. Much better. Nice vault, handspring, half twist into a back somersault. You see she comes on exactly the way she did for the first vault, handspring. It's kind of in between. I think they'll probably go front half. It's kind of in between a front half and a half back. See where that twist occurs. I think it's supposed to be a half twist back somersault, which is called a cuervo.
Amanda's partner in round two.
Now we're going to take a look at Amanda's partner from Great Britain. This is Neil Thomas. Be ready to perform on the floor exercise. He was 20th in the all-around at the Olympic Games, and he's been a finalist in the World Championships on this event, the floor exercise. He has a spectacular move right here at the beginning of the routine. Oh, unfortunately, he put his hands down. Here's also a terrific combination. You don't see many gymnasts do a double twisting front flip.
Especially not that easily.
It's really unfortunate that he had to put his hands down. That's a major deduction for his opening tumbling run. And he really is such a terrific specialist on this event. I'm really surprised that he's having trouble. Power, and he really has nice looking style too. Here's his dismount. Full twisting double back. Once again, a routine that was packed with difficulty, but unfortunately, a major error at the beginning of the exercise. This is the last tumbling pass. It's a full twisting double back. It's a very difficult move to use at the end of the routine. Full in, back out. So the scores for our first pair in this second round of competition. Amanda Borden had a 9.337, the average of her two vault. Neil Thomas had an 8.7 on flow exercise. Their team total to this point is 36.712. Now from China, this is Hei Shuamei, the 16-year-old. She'll be performing on the vault.
She's performing the Yurchenko, laid out with a full twist, probably the most common vault in women's gymnastics at this point. They've actually devalued it to a 9.8. She didn't quite hit the height or the distance that she would have liked, especially in order to maintain that laid out position. She had to pipe down, took a pretty large step on the landing. Ordinarily, this wouldn't have hurt her so much because she would have had a second opportunity to perform the second vault, go for a better amplitude and a better landing. But now they have to average both vaults. So you can see she never reached a laid out position. And she landed very close to the horse and took that step. She needs to come up with a much better second ball. But the Chinese typically have not been strong vaulters. They lack the power, the physical power, some of the best vaulters in the world, their strengths.
9.3 is the score for her first vault, so as you mentioned, she's going to really need to nail a good vault here if she hopes to help her team in the second round.
Much better vault. You can see she landed farther from the horse. She lifted off higher off the horse. She still had that pike down. So that will be the deduction in that vault. But certainly much better. You can see here she lifts off the horse much better and gets into the stretched position. If only briefly, and then she has to pike down for the landing and hop back.
Shuibei's partner be performing on men's parallel bars in round two. He has a twin brother, Li Xiaoshuang, who is also...
Now we'll go over to the parallel bars and take a look at Li Daxuang. As we mentioned earlier, his twin brother is the Olympic gold medalist on the floor exercise in Barcelona. Li also a silver medalist in those games. He says, when we compete, we are rivals, but afterwards, we're just brothers and good friends. Oh, he had to bend his arms on that swing to a handstand there. Three underbar moves in a row. One of the elements that the judges seem to really be encouraging. They like to see the underbar work. And he fulfilled that requirement. Unfortunately, with the bent arm and the swing to a handstand, it's really going to cost him.
All right, you know what I found amazing in that routine? The landing on the dismount, most gymnasts would have given that up and stepped backwards or even fallen backwards, and he was able to come up with a pretty decent landing.
Let's take a look at what happens here. He's doing a sequence of Healy twirls, and on the second one, he has to bend his arms and push back up to handstand. That's an unfortunate error. This is the best part of the routine, is the underbar work, the giant with a half turn. So the scores for the Chinese team in the second round, an average of 9.387 for Hei on the vault. Li had an 8.533 on parallel bars. 17.920 is their score in the second round, with a total of 36.903. We'll be back with more of gymnastics right after this.
Welcome back to U.S. Olympic Gold. We'll have more of the Reebok International Mixed Pairs competition in just a few minutes. But first, a look at a special young lady. In the 1992 Olympic Games in Barcelona, Carrie Strug was the youngest member of the entire U.S. contingent. A little dynamo in her own right, Carrie has spent 12 of her 15 years dedicated to the sport of gymnastics, a commitment that she says has been well worth it. Who could resist a face like this? She was the picture-perfect little girl, complete with ponytails and a flawless smile. Now at the age of 15, Carrie Strug is the quintessential gymnast and one of the top athletes in her sport, a level that she's achieved through self-discipline.
I just like to do well, and you put so much time and effort, and I know that my family has too, and so I want the results to be good.
The results were excellent. Carrie reached her important goal by making the 92 U.S. Olympic gymnastics team, an accomplishment that came through much preparation.
Well, it was really exciting to be on the Olympic team because I had dreamed about it my whole life. And then when you finally reach your goal, you realize that all the hard work and everything you went through was worth it because, I don't know, it just always seemed so far away, like a dream, and then I made it, so it was really great.
Nice.
She reached that goal with the assistance of the gymnastics guru himself, Bella Karoly. Carrie was one of the many gymnasts that he helped develop their talent. But after the Olympics, Karoly announced his retirement, prompting Carrie to move to Oklahoma to train with the man they say represents the future of U.S. gymnastics, Steve Nuno.
I felt that this was in my best interest to come here, and I didn't want to be somewhere where I wasn't going to be the best. You know, if I'm going to make the commitment to live away from home and train 8 hours a day and all that, I think I should make the total commitment.
Being able to achieve the level of success that Carrie has obviously requires a few sacrifices. Like most elite gymnasts, she's had to move away from her hometown where there are family and friends. So it makes her treasure the few moments when they're together. While in Oklahoma City, Carrie lives with teammate Mariana Webster and her mother, Melanie. But she can't wait for the time when her mom comes to visit.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, I missed you.
We really didn't want Carrie to do gymnastics. I think when you're at a really high level in gymnastics, as in several other sports, ice skating and tennis, usually you do have to leave home. And we knew that that would eventually probably be the case with Carrie. And I mean, if I had had my way, she would have been a tennis player. Living in Arizona, we had tennis courts more or less almost in our backyard. But she always liked gymnastics.
It's that love for the sport that brings her to the same program as Olympian Shannon Miller. And the perspective that both gymnasts share that caught Steve Nuno's attention.
I saw the same thing I saw in Shannon Miller. I saw a desire to succeed, a desire, a work ethic that was, help me, I'm willing to put out the effort, you show me the way, and I'll go.
I've done a lot of things that most teenagers don't get to do, you know, like travel all over the world and be in the Olympics, and I get the self-satisfaction of doing well, and I have plenty of time after my gymnastics to do the other sort of things that, you know, normal kids do, because gymnastics only lasts a short while, and I want to do it while I can.
Well, right now, Carrie is in high school with a perfect grade point average of 4.0 and says she would like to become a pediatrician. I'd say with her determination, that won't be a problem. There's more of the Reebok International Mixed Pair, so let's return to the Omni, where Carrie is getting ready for her first vault.
There is Coach Steve Nuno, coach of Shannon Miller, of course, the most celebrated woman athlete at the 92 Games, and now coach of this young lady, Carrie Strug. Here's her vault.
A very nice vault. She's very tough on this event, very powerful. You can see the concentration. She wants to stick those landings. She really got some valuable experience competing at the Olympic Games, winning a bronze medal with the team.
Boy, that was really well done. Good landing, good body position.
Nearly the only deduction there, slight leg separation on the pre-flight and right before the landing, but that goes by so quickly, it's hard to say if the judges could even see it.
A lot of fans for Carrie Strug here in the audience. 9.7 is the score for her first vault, so they're off to a terrific start.
Keep in mind, the vault's only worth a 9.8, so they saw very few faults in the vault. Another good vault!
Even a little bit better, don't you think?
I think it was more dynamic. She did have the slight hop on the landing.
She has finally a little look of relief in her face after that one.
See here, as she makes contact with the horse, that's really the only deduction on the pre-flight. Slight leg separation, and just the hop on the landing. Very minor deductions.
So a strong performance for Carrie Strug in the second round, and now she's yelling across the gym at her teammate, Chris Waller. Chris is getting ready to perform on High Bar, which is one of his best events and one of the events where he has his highest level of difficulty. Of course, this American pair not only needs to finish in the top three, but they have to beat Miller and Ringnald to move on into the final round. He needs an 8.2 for them to take the lead so far in this round. His releases. And again. Well done. This routine seems like a marathon. It's long. Obviously, he has to do that to fulfill all the requirements. Here's the big dismount, double-double. Whoa!
Whoa!
That's the best landing I've ever seen out of Chris Waller.
Talk about putting the pressure on. Only one American pair can move on to the third round. And that puts a lot of pressure on Shannon and Lance.
Let's take a look at the release moves. This is the reverse hecht, right into the ginger, the combination. Well done there. And the dismount, it's very difficult to keep your body square while there's so much flipping and twisting going on. But he really squares it up and lands right on top of it. That's the best I've ever seen him do that. So as we wait for the scores for Carrie Strug and Chris Waller, keep in mind that they trail Miller and Ringnald by .017. Their scores are 9.687 for Carrie Strug and a 9.333, a little low it seems, for Chris Waller on the high bar. 38.053. That puts him in first place in this round, but keep in mind there's a lot of pressure coming from the other American pair, Shannon Miller and Lance Ringnald. Now we move over to the vault. This is Yelena Piskun from Belarus.
This should be very exciting. This is where the team from Belarus can move up. Double twist. Oh! She landed with her feet a little bit one in front of the other. But that is a tough vault. It's worth a 10.0.
Just a reminder, if you missed it earlier, we talked about the
that is the highest rated vault that we've seen today from the women competing here.
Keep in mind, Carrie's and Shannon's both are worth a 9.8 maximum. Double twist. She really worked for that landing because she was coming in a little bit short. She pulled it out.
So keep that in mind tonight as we go on through the competition, especially for the men.
She'll perform the same vault again. Really, she's going to try and improve on that, keep the legs together, land with them together, get a little bit higher
now ready
off
for
the horse so she can finish the flip and the twist. in time for a better landing.
9.775 is the score for the first vault for Piskun.
Much better vault. You can see she landed a little bit farther away from the horse. It's a little more stretched in the air. Didn't have to pike down quite as much.
Boy, there's a whole lot going on in the air in this vault.
And it happens in very short amount of time. Right there, 1-2, and she really pulls that second one around.
We're now ready for the other competitor from Memphis.
Score 9.80, as you said, a little bit better. So we'll take the average of those two vaults and add them to the score from Vitaly Scherbo, who's getting ready now to go on the floor exercise. And this performance here could prove to be one of the highlights of the evening. He is one of the most spectacular tumblers in the world. Watch this first move. Laid out, full out, and he totally nailed it. We've seen Scherbo even use a double twisting, double layout to open his routine.
Which is why that looked so easy. It was for him.
He has such a feel for the presentation of the routine. Never in a hurry, shows really powerful tumbling. If he scores a 9.333 or higher, they will take the lead over Carrie Strug and Chris Waller in this round. There's a scale on 1 foot that is a requirement, and here's his last tumbling pass. Laid out, double back. Oh! A big jump on the landing, something you don't see from Vitaly Scherbo.
That's a tough dismount, double laid out somersault. Most gymnasts open their floor routines with a skill like that.
It's interesting, we were talking to him when he arrived today. He arrived late because he's tending to his newborn child, and he said, I don't sleep, I change diapers all night long, so perhaps he is excused this week anyway. And his last tumbling run, you can see what happens here. This is, as you mentioned, Kathy, one of the most difficult moves to do at the end of the routine.
And normally he does not break form at all, and you can see his knees are a little bit bent, slightly apart, not much. You could tell he was working more than he usually does. He has to take a giant step forward, but he kept his hands off the ground.
The winner of 6 gold medals in Barcelona, a record. The score for Scherbo is a 9.333. So even with that error on the last tumbling pass for Vitaly Scherbo, that does move them into first place in the second round of competition with a 38.086. After such a phenomenal success for Shannon Miller, winner of 5 medals at the Olympics in Barcelona, Kathy talked to her about how tough was it to get back in the gym after those Olympics.
After the Olympics, I only had about a couple days off, so it was a little bit easier to get back into gymnastics then, because it didn't really feel like I should stop or anything. But then I went on a tour for about 5 or 6 weeks, and I worked out during the tour, but not quite as much as normal. And so after the tour, it's been a little bit harder to get back into full sets in top shape.
Here are your leaders after the first round of competition, Shannon Miller and Lance Ringnault. Shannon will be vaulting in this round. Kathy, as you mentioned, Shannon gave us a thrill in Barcelona, nailing the best vault of her life in the finals of the all-around.
She certainly showed us she could handle the pressure. The pressure's on here. Oh! A very uncharacteristic step.
Now this is an interesting point because with the new rules, remember in the past the gymnasts take the best of the two vaults. Because they're averaging these vaults, that could hurt them today.
This vault is worth a 9.8, and that is a minimum of 1/10 of a point on that step, and that's a large step, so they really can take a little bit more.
An excellent student. Let that be a lesson to your young gymnast. You can perform in the gym and also get a 4.0 grade point average.
I think it's important to note here for particularly the people that saw Shannon compete at the Olympics and watch her perform 16 for 16 perfect routines. It's very difficult to maintain that level of intensity.
9.65 was the score for her first fall. She'll need to do better here.
Much better. A little hot forward, but she's much happier with that vault. Still, I see a little look of worry on her face. Not sure if it's going to be enough. You can see she's a little short on the front end of the horse. Just a little hop on the landing.
We were talking to Shannon the other day. She said before the Olympics, she had a micro screw put in her elbow before the games, and she said she had it taken out the other day, and she said, what about a micro screw? She said the thing was about 2 inches long.
I don't see how it fit in that tiny elbow.
9.70 is the score for her second vault, so those will be averaged and added to the score now of Lance Ringnall, who's going to perform on the steel rings. A lot of pressure here on Lance because I have to admit, this is not one of Lance's best events. He'll have to be very solid here if he hopes to move into the final round along with Shannon Miller. He needs a score of 9.33 or better. He opens with a flange, kip to a plunge. Looks a little bit more like a Maltese. It's a very low plunge. All of the gymnasts looking for ways of fulfilling the bonus requirements to get the big scores. There is one of the requirements, a swing to a handstand. And the dismount is a full twisting double back in the tucked position. Now it'll be very interesting to see what the judges do with that routine because it was not packed with difficulty. Remember, a 9.33 will move them ahead of Strug and Waller into the final round of competition. A 9.366 will move them into the overall lead in this competition. Here's the dismount. It's a double back with a full twist in the tucked position. One of the more common dismounts right now. And will not get him any bonus points. So the score for Shannon Miller, a 9.675 on the vault. The score on the rings for Lance Ringgold, only a 9.30. So they get bumped out of the second round of competition, will not go on to the finals. The American team to represent in the finals is Kerry Strug and Chris Waller. A big disappointment for the five-time Olympic medalist to not make it to the final round. So here are your results after the second round of competition. The final three teams that go on into the third round are Piskun and Sherbo from Belarus with a 38.086, Strug and Waller from the United States with a 38.053, and actually Miller and Ringnall would be in third place normally, but because only one American pair is allowed to go on into the final round of competition, the pair from China moves in, He and Li, with a 36.903. So here are your finalists, the top three that move on into the third round of competition. From Belarus, Piskun and Sherbo with a 38.086. Strug and Waller from the United States with a 38.053. It's very close. And from China, He and Li, 36.903. Well, Kathy, as we get ready for the third and final round of competition, the American pair of Strug and Waller are .033 behind the team from Belarus. Can they catch them?
Kerry has chosen balance beam for her last event. That's very, very risky, but she has been solid. She hit at the American Cup. Piskun is excellent on the uneven bar, so it's hard to say. They're really, really close. And He Shua Mei is superb on balance beam, but I think she's going to miss some bonus points there, so that's going to hurt her.
And the Chinese are really too far behind to challenge the top two spots, so we'll see what happens.
now we're like...
On the uneven bars, this is Kiskun. She has a really unusual style, and what a big move she has coming up here.
Absolutely beautiful. Full and a half twisting release move. She's very aggressive on this event.
I'll say.
You can see she loses a little bit of form. But the level of difficulty is superb.
How about the technique on these giant swings? This is something really different.
She doesn't pike through like most people do. And unfortunately, it caused her to bend her legs on that second giant, which will be a form deduction. Form deduction on the dismount and also the step backwards. Be interesting to see what the judges do with it.
Remember now, this is a mixed pair team competition, so that could hurt their team. She had a couple of form...
release move. As you can see, it's way up above the bar, but she does have little form deduction.
Well, now over to the parallel bars for the final performance from Vitaly Scherbo, the wonder kid of men's gymnastics. He is such a pleasure to watch because he does very exciting and entertaining routines. He just seems to know how to find the handstand every time. The back tosses right on top. And the pike double back. He nails his landings like a knife going into a soft mat. He just cuts it like a dart.
Part, I really think it's a combination of his incredible talent, but also the level of the intensity of his work. His workouts, he says, are so advanced. He puts so many hours into the gym, and they say that they really work harder than everybody in the world.
His dismount is the pike double back somersault. Look at the form, and he lands like a dart landing into a dartboard. He never moves. The score on the uneven bars for Piskun is 9.575. We wait on the score for Vitaly Scherbo.
The scores are coming.
9.566 is his score. So there is room for the American pair of Carrie Strug and Chris Waller. Before we get a chance to see the final American pair, we turn now to the Chinese team, Hei Shua Mei on the balance beam. And although they're not really in contention for first place here, this is one really spectacular balance beam routine to watch.
Moving right along, our next competitor will be on women's balance.
Like all her Chinese teammates, she is so beautiful on this event, always showing full flexibility. A much more creative approach to choreography on this event than most of the other countries. Watch this mount. She pressed up to the handstand. Now, this is a skill we've seen quite often on men's parallel bars.
Looks like a pretty rough landing there.
Beautiful extension. This is a very difficult skill. Should be a round off, full twisting back.
Oh!
Oh no. Ooh, that's a bad miss on balance beam. Hopefully she was able to miss the side of her body on the beam. You can see she has a slight bruise on her leg. That's from a landing similar to that, where you hit the beam a little.
Kathy, there's some controversy. Some people seem to think that the judges requiring the gymnast to do such a high level of difficulty is maybe forcing the gymnast to try
too difficult of moves. Do you feel that's the truth?
I actually don't, Bart. I really don't think a gymnast would perform a skill that they were not capable of performing at least 10 out of 10 times in a practice session successfully.
And actually, it seems like the gymnasts want to do the hard moves anyway, whether the judges require it or not.
Right, that's not the only part of the change in the code of points. They're also encouraging the combination of elements and original skills. So it's not just the extra difficult skills they're looking for. Watch the control she has on this skill. Lifts one arm up and just twists right down. And unfortunately, this is one of the most difficult skills being done on balance beam. She does it in laid out position, and I have never seen it done in that position. Yeah, I think she caught just by little her side as she came down the beam.
This evening and competing for his country of China on steel rings. Please welcome back again.
We move now to her teammate, Li Dashuang. He'll be performing on the steel rings. There's a tremendous emphasis by the judges in requiring the gymnast to show a lot of strength moves. Let's see what he uses here. There's a plunge and a press to a handstand. A requirement, you must press to a handstand. Two more strength moves. It's imperative that the gymnasts hold the rings very steady in the hold positions, like the handstand there. And a laid out double back somersault. All right, well, that routine is not going to have enough difficulty to score really well.
And Bart, one more word on the difficulty level and if they're encouraging gymnasts to do too difficult skills. And I said I didn't think so. These skills have been done years and years ago. What they're encouraging them to do now is take the risk and perform them, but it's not a risk of health or injury.
Right.
It's a risk of hitting them and taking a deduction for a fall or a missed element.
The score now for the Chinese pair in the final round. He had a 9.1 on the balance beam, and Li on the rings had an 8.966. And still to come, we have the U.S. team of Chris Waller and Kerry Strug as they try to take the title away from the team from Belarus.
Olympic gold has been brought to you by Reebok, who reminds you that on Planet Reebok, there are no limits.
Kerry Strug now ready to perform on the balance beam. This is the final mixed pair team performance tonight. She and her teammate Chris Waller have to average a 9.6 in these routines if they hope to take the lead and win this title.
Perform this exact routine at the American Cup. The start value of the routine is a 9.9, which is the maximum she can score.
She has a routine with a super value, as you mentioned, a 9.9. Chris Waller has a routine on the rings that isn't worth as much, so he'll have to be very clean and have no execution errors.
It's interesting, she has a skill in this routine that she presented to the judges. It's actually not in the code of points yet, and they valued it as a D, which is certainly to her benefit. I'll be sure to point that out when she performs it.
From the United States, Miss Kerry Strug.
She's only 15 years old. She's been in two world championships and one Olympics, and she could go a long way still.
Requirements on balance beam to perform a gymnastics series. She She also gets a bonus for that, 0.2 points for combining two difficult gymnastics elements. And that's a back kite somersault. I think what they'd ultimately like to see it as is a layout. That's her skill, switch leg into a straddle jump. They have valued that as a D element. As I was saying, the pike, they'd like to see that in a layout position. Then she can get that 0.1 point bonus, and her routine would be worth a 10. The judges have said they're going to be very, very strict on awarding those extra bonus points. They really want the skill done properly and with full amplitude.
Very aggressive routine.
I have to tell you, this is very good for Carrie because she told us a while back. Nice routine. She told us a while back that sometimes she gets too nervous in competition and will have misses. And it's important for her to show herself that she can handle this kind of pressure.
Well, a slight smile from Carrie Strug, and then back to the seriousness. This was an exciting pass.
Once again, this meet is being taped and will be replayed.
These
on
are her layout step outs.
US Olympic gold.
Of course, the deduction here will be the slight leg bends, something she really wants to work on before the World Championships.
Ladies and gentlemen, the final competitor.
This puts a lot of pressure on her teammate, Chris Waller, getting ready to perform on the still rings. Chris has had some success on the rings.
Please welcome back Chris Waller.
He was a bronze medalist in the Goodwill Games back in 1990 in Seattle on this event. L cross. Kip to another L cross. The score for Carrie Strug is a 9.6. As we mentioned, they have to average 9.6, so Waller would need to match that score. So far, he's very clean, a little high in the inverted iron cross. That'll be tough to get the full points for that move. Holding the handstands very solid. Nice dismount. Let's take a look at that dismount. It's a laid out double back with a full twist. He does take a slight hop on the landing. And keep in mind, at the recent American Cup, that routine only scored 9.35. So it's going to be tough for Waller to get the 9.6. Okay, the scores for the American pair, 9.6, as we mentioned, for Carrie Strug. And on rings for Chris Waller, only a 9.333. So not enough. So here are your final standings. The team from Belarus, Piskun and Sherbo, take the first prize. Second place goes to Carrie Strug and Chris Waller. And Hay and Lee from China get the bronze. Kathy Johnson is with our second place team, Carrie Strug and Chris Waller.
Carrie, Chris, it was so close. We're talking 0.1 points. But Carrie, you have to be proud of yourself. I remember you telling me you used to get so nervous sometimes in competition that you'd have a miss. You were just solid as could be today.
Yeah, I'm happy with my performance overall. I had no major breaks this whole week, and so I was happy with that. But there's still room for improvement. I had some minor bobbles and not some stick landings that maybe we could have won it if I had. But, you know, if we're going to be second, like Chris said, I'm fine to be second to Sherbo.
And Chris, I said this to Lance, the code is what is really getting you guys. What do you have to say about that?
Yeah, the code is pretty scary. Seeing scores come up after a great routine that's a 9.3 or 9.25, you know, 9.4s are unusual. So that's scary, but most important thing is go out and do the best routine you can. And I did a bunch of good routines, and I was paired with the best girl here tonight, so I'm happy.
You both did great routines. Congratulations.
Thank you. And congratulations to all the gymnasts in tonight's competition. For many of them, they're off to Birmingham, England for the World Gymnastics Championships. Well, that's the story from here in Atlanta at the Reebok International Mixed Pairs Gymnastics Competition. For Kathy Johnson, I'm Bart Connor. We'll see you next time.
A footnote for gymnastics, the World Championships were held in Birmingham, England this weekend, and six-time Olympic gold medalist Vitaly Sherbo has won the men's all-around competition, while American Shannon Miller picked up the gold, and Dominique Dawes placed fourth on the women's side. Let's roll on and take a look at what's happening next week. It's a live broadcast of diving, the U.S. Indoor Nationals from Austin, Texas. Headlining the list of competitors vying for six national titles is Mark Lindsay, a six-time U.S. springboard champion. He's joined by other 92 Olympians, platform bronze medalist Mary Ellen Clark, and the silver medalist in men's platform from Barcelona, Scott Doney. So join us for the U.S. Indoor Nationals in diving on next week's U.S. Olympic Gold. Until then, I'm Nicole Watson saying goodnight from all of us here in Atlanta.